माय ऑडिबल? एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अ सेशन एट डीबीएमएस. इन अ प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिस्कस द प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 5. ओके, इन दिस सेशन वी विल कवर द नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल, प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 6. सो आई शेयर द कंटेंट ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल. Okay, so this is your practical number 6. In a practical number 6, we perform each and every practical by using PLSQL block. Okay, so you all familiar with the PLSQL? What is PLSQL? PLSQL is a combination of SQL along with the procedural features of procedural programming language or procedural language, structured query language. Okay, so it's also developed by Oracle Corporation, and the PLSQL is one of the three key programming language embedded in the Oracle database along with the SQL itself. And one thing, Java is also covered in this corporation. Okay, so in this practical, first we study about, first question is, write a PLSQL code for calculate accept two value from user and any operator like plus, minus, multiplication and division. We will perform this operation plus, minus, multiplication and division, all this operation. Okay, so for PLSQL block, if you create a procedural language or structured query language that is a completely portable and high performance transaction processing language, it provides a built-in interpreted and OS independent programming environment. PLSQL can also directly called from the command line SQL plus interface. Okay, some of the features covered in a PLSQL, like PLSQL is a tightly integrated with SQL. It offers the error checking as well as numerous data type and programming structure. It support structure programming through the function and procedure, and also support object oriented programming. Okay, so let's start. First of all, we require to create a simple program. Okay, like block of code. So I share notepad screen of the notepad. So if you create a particular file, I save as this file as a p6 underscore 1 point 6 underscore 1, that is your first question or a program we create for SQL. So SQL, So your first experiment is write a PL SQL code for calculator, accept a two value from user. User enter any two value like integer value, okay, 5 and 6, and accept any operator. So we will perform this operation, arithmetic operation, plus, minus, multiplication and division. Okay, so first of all we required a declare section. Okay, declare. In this declare section, this is the same as we declare in our programming language C language or Java, like data type and variable name, integer, integer A. Okay, we previously applied as a integer A in a Java or C language. Okay, but if you want to declare here in a PL SQL, so write a proper word declare. Then here you can declare by using any integer value A as a integer. Okay, and I use second value B as a integer. Okay, then to summation of two numbers A and B, like A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 6, so we required a third variable to store the answer. So I use here, I'm taking one more variable like answer as integer. Okay, then after apply this declare section, declare means declaration is done. We required all these three variable A, B and answer. All three variable with the same data type integer. Okay, now we use begin section, begin, to start the code or whatever the logic we applied here. A is equal to %. A, that means user want to enter a value, okay, value of A. So by this way you can scan a value from user. Same thing for B, colon is equal to %. B, okay, and answer, if you want to perform the answer, so it's a simple A plus B. We required a summation of A and B, so A plus B. In C programming or in Java, we use a print statement, like in Java system dot output dot println, in double quote we write a message that particular we want to print. Okay, same thing in a C programming, we use printf function, printf statement to print a particular message. Okay, and here we are using DBMS, the underscore output dot put underscore line. By using this statement you can print any message or particular value. Okay, so first of all we use this for addition. So like we are using here addition. Addition is, and by using this pipe sign, okay, it concatenate with your answer. We required this all this step, like we perform this operation for addition. So we required for subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, so copy this all for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Instead of this plus sign, माइनस हियर सब्ट्रैक्शन देन मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिवीजन। ओके so we perform all the operation addition subtraction multiplication and division and each and every operation perform the arithmetic operation and store the value in answer variable so we use a third variable answer okay here we required a division okay after completing all the statement we write a DBMS last thing is your end statement so each and every PL SQL block here we start with a declare section then begin section and each and every PL SQL block with a end with end keyword okay done so this is your first experiment just to check if any error so it will define or it will display error or warning message before performing this all operation we required one statement like set server output on okay we required because this is necessary to perform each and every PL SQL operation okay so I connect run SQL command line okay for that I share a window wait a minute so screen is visible all of you command line screen is visible or not SQL command okay now connect your database with a username and password so your database is connected now I copy this all code set server output on from starting this one I copy all the code in this here unknown set server wait a minute it run but again I try to run because here some problem set server output on it has some value enter a value of a so let's try with enter a value a is equal to 10 so by default some of the value will provided old value is equal to 6 okay and we enter a is equal to 10% a so your new value after checking A is equal to 10 then we applied and enter the value for B is 5 so this is a updated value, and PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Okay, but no any answer retrieved here. So we check the set server output on. Here we required to update this one. Okay, I think I try again. Value of A is equal to 10. You can use any value and 5. Now check. Addition is 15, 10 plus 5, 15. Subtraction is equal to 5, 10 minus 5. It's okay. Then multiplication is 50, 5, 0. It's working. And division is 2. Clear, all of you? All of you understand or not? We perform the arithmetic operation by using PL SQL block. Clear, all of you? Okay. So each and every PL SQL block end with this AND and slash sign. So remember this slash sign to complete your PL SQL block. Any doubt? Okay. So you can do any operation by using this PL SQL block. Okay. Simple, we first declare the value in this declare section. Declare, that means we initialize the particular value by using a operate here variable. Okay. A and B, two variable we are using, and A and B both are integer type. Third variable we require to store the answer. Okay. A is equal to user entered the value of A and B. So we required ampersand, same like in a C programming. And we perform operation. Answer is equal to A plus B. Here we change A minus B. So subtraction, multiplication, and division. That's on. Okay. Clear, all of you? Any doubt? So one message will appear after complete successfully of your PL SQL block. PL SQL procedure successfully completed. This is a procedure. Okay. We perform each and every group of operation here and combine operation that's using a PL SQL block. Declare, begin, and end section. Okay. Now read second question. Write a PL SQL code for add 50% salary of Riya and 70% salary of Reema to salary of Rekha. That means we required modify a salary, okay, update a salary. So first of all, create this employee table, because this type of a table not available in our database previously. Not we created any employee table with this database, this inserted record. So all of you try employee table or EMP table. You can choose any name for your table. Here employee, instead of employee, you can use a EMP table, but value or inserted record remains same. Okay, to check. So all of you to create one employee table. employee table, select star from employee. Instead of this actual value, I am using other value, okay? 8,600, 8,000. But use here 10,006. Okay. Then after creating the table, you require to insert this value to display all this record into table name. Okay. Then values. Please tell me if creation of table and insertion of data completed. You can use any data type, varchar 2 or number data type. Okay. Here use a varchar 2 for name and for salary, user number data type. So in my PLSQL block, please tell me necessary changes that's we require. All of you done with your employee table? Created or not? So first of all, I required declaration. We required a 3 integer type variable, so I am using R1 as a integer. Okay. R2 again integer type, and R3 integer. Okay. In the begin section, I write a select statement, select query, select salary into R1. Okay, R1 is temporary registered or one variable we use to store the value. So select the salary into R1 from which table? We are using employee table. So right here, employee, where name is equal to, just to check, we require 50% salary of first Riya, then Rima to Rekha. So where name is equal to Riya. Okay. That means R1 is equal to, we perform the operation, R1 is equal to like this way, R1 into 0.5, clear. And here we are using 70% salary of Rima. So R1 is equal to R1 into 0.5. Okay. Then repeat this step for select salary into R2. Now we use the second variable R2 from employee table again, name with instead of Riya, Rima, and here R2 is R2 into 0.7. Okay. And what is the value of R3? R3 we use for Rekha. Okay. So R3 is equal to 1 plus R2. Okay. We apply 0.5% and 0.7%. Okay. But performing this operation, that means we update okay. So what is the actual query for update? Update table name, then set column name. So salary is one column in employee table. So update employee set salary is equal to R3, where name is equal to Rekha. Okay. And is already written here and slash. Okay, we update employee salary like name with Rekha. We update the salary R1 and R2, addition of R1 and R2 to this Rekha. Okay, so clear any syntax problem or anything, just to check. Now copy wait a minute. Set server output on and declare all things is okay. Now PLSQL procedural successful completed. PLSQL procedure successfully completed. Now if you want to check our record after updating this information, so simply select star from employee, just check here 8200 and previously 800. So we applied this operation and add salary to Rekha's account. Clear all of you? Here my information like Riya have 8000 and Rima have that record. According to this record, this is the value 8000 and 6000. So updated record in Rekha's account is 8200. Clear? All of you. So you required this code और क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, योर आंसर में भी डिफरेंट बिकॉज रिया रिया सैलरी लाइक 10,000 एंड रीमा सैलरी इज 6,000। ओके क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू? All of you clear? You can apply any operation. Here we applied a multiplication with 0.5. If you require any changes, so you can do any changes. But the SQL query remains same. Okay, previously we all studied about this query, select salary into R1. We required this value into this variable, so we are using this into and variable name, into in and variable name. And for update, like addition of R1 and R2, we store the result in R3. So update query is update table name set column name is equal to value. Your actual value or final value is R3. Okay, and the condition is where name is equal to Rekha. All of you clear? Question number two. Okay. Now try for question number 3. Write a PLSQL code to give the maximum salary of Rima or Rekha to Riya. What is the meaning of this query? Use a maximum salary. Maximum is one aggregate function. Okay. So how can we use? Select max. In the bracket salary, salary is one column, and we store this result into particular variable. Okay, to apply this result we use a where condition where name is equal to Rima or where name is equal to Rekha. Also we update by using update query, update employee set salary is equal to whatever we save previous, like in variable, third variable. Okay, so where name is equal to Riya, same like a previous query. Maximum salary of Rima or Rekha. Okay, this is a combined approach. So maximum salary of Rima or Rekha will assign to Riya. Okay, so only we update last information. First we check a maximum salary and stored in a particular variable. Clear about this question? Okay, so try yourself. क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, so for question number 3, write a PLSQL code to give a maximum salary of Prima or Rekha to Riya. Use this table, employee table. Okay, so again we required a declare any variable like salary as integer. Okay, then in the begin section select statement, select maximum salary, so max is one aggregate function, then write salary, okay, into this variable SAL salary, from which table? Employee table. Okay, when condition we applied where name is equal to Rima or name is equal to Riya. Okay, sorry, Rekha. Then we required one more query, update employee. Okay, set salary is equal to salary SAL, where name is equal to Riya. Completed. All of you clear? So use this code in your PLSQL PLSQL procedure successfully completed. Okay, to run this program or check the output, select star from employee. So we update this information, add to Riya's account. So Riya account updated 8200 क्लियर। ऑल ऑफ यू क्लियर? क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री। क्वेश्चन और एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क अ क्वेश्चन इफ एनी डाउट। सो ट्राई फॉर नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर। राइट अ PLSQL कोड दैट विल एक्सेप्ट एम्प्लॉय नंबर एंड डेबिट अमाउंट फ्रॉम यूजर। इफ बैलेंस इज बिलो 500, whenever you debit the amount then give error message, okay, because if your account have a below 500 you want below 100, otherwise whatever you debit that's reflect into your original table, account table, okay. So first of all, here we required one temporary account table, okay. So all of you create one account table, and you can store any random number and random information, dummy information like A001 is your account number, your name and balance whatever 10,000 or 15,000, okay. This type of a table first we required, okay. So create one table that contain the information, column like account number, okay. We directly use without any constraint, so no need to add any primary key, directly add account number and name, use name, and salary, okay. Likewise, okay. So create this table and apply any name like account or ACC account table. In a PLSQL block, we use this employee number, okay, as a temporary variable, okay. But we require the HUL table and here the information related to table because we applied a debit. So all of you done account table.
कंप्लीटेड।
ओके एंड इंसर्ट अ रिकॉर्ड, इंसर्शन ऑफ रिकॉर्ड, डन। नाउ लेट्स ट्राई। आई ऑलरेडी क्रिएट वन टेबल, अकाउंट टेबल, तो सिलेक्ट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ACC underscore 6, I think I create one table. Okay, this is my table. Select star from table name. Table is account underscore 6 because we work on a practical number 6. So this account number contained the record A001 with the name and balance 10,000. Second record and third record. Clear? This is our actual information in database. Now we required a PLSQL block to perform this query. Like write a PLSQL code that will accept employee number. So we use employee number as one variable and debit particular amount from user. And we check if balance below 500. So message will display below balance below 500. Otherwise, information will update. Okay. So I delete all these things. And start with declare section to declare a variable. Okay. As we applied in a table, we required a three variable. First one account number, so we use here employee number. Okay. As a varchar to. Maximum size is 5. Then debit we required one variable debit as a number. If you require to display any name, so you can use a name as a varchar too. Okay. But here only we perform operation, so we required a necessary variables only 7,2, that means if any integer and float value covered. Okay, then balance again in a number data type. Okay, 7,2 maximum. You can use 7 digit as a decimal and 2 digit as a floating point. Okay, then begin. Here employee underscore number, you can use any number. So user can input a number by using & emp number. Debit same, you can use any amount for debit, it's your choice. So this is a debit, and right now we use a select operation, select balance into my new variable balance BAL. Okay, from which table? I am using A score 6 because my table already available in database account underscore 6. Okay, you required existing table for your SQL query. Then one condition where ACC underscore 6 underscore account underscore number or account underscore number is equal to EMP underscore number, and we check a condition if balance less than 500 okay, without any confusion I am using balance directly here, okay, because balance is one column available also in a table. If balance less than 500, then one message we require. Which message? DBMS underscore output underscore sorry dot put underscore line. By this way you can print a message. Which message we required? This one, balance below 500. Okay, so this is your message and this is the amount. So use a slash sign and dash. Okay, we use this because this is the last entry. That means user or other user can't modify your data. So we generally use a manually slash and dash. Then if and else. So else portion, otherwise means else portion. Okay, update the table information. How can we update a table information? By using update query, update table name. So table name is ACC underscore 6. Okay, set balance is equal to minus debit. We required a debit operation, so your actual balance is current balance. That means a balance minus debit, where one condition account number is equal to employee number. Clear? And finally, if this occur, so we required one simple message, update output dot put underscore line. Now message is check if your account is updated. So we required a debit this amount is debited from account of, you can concat by using again pipe symbol, from which table, we use this information DBMS underscore output dot put underscore line. Debit means particular amount, whatever we debit, okay, and this amount is debited एम्प्लॉय नंबर दिस डेबिटेड फ्रॉम अमाउंट अकाउंट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर एम्प्लॉय नंबर, सो राइट हियर एमपी नंबर, ओके। नाउ दिस एफ इफ कंप्लीटेड बाय यूजिंग एंड इफ, सो राइट एंड इफ, ओके। एंड कॉलन स्लैश, वी रिक्वायर्ड हियर सेमी कॉलन, जस्ट चेक एल्स स्टेटमेंट नॉट कवर एनी सेमी कॉलन, इफ देन कंडीशन, अदरवाइज दिस इज परफॉर्म, ओके। एंड हियर वी स्कैन अ पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू एंड रिक्वायर्ड आउटपुट, सो सेट सर्वर आउटपुट ऑन, ओके। लेट्स वी ट्राई टू चेक दिस PLSQL ब्लॉक, इफ एनी एरर सो इट विल डिस्प्ले एरर मैसेज, वी विल सॉर्ट बाय चेकिंग इन अ कंपाइलर, ओके। Enter a value for employee number. You can use any number, like employee number is 3. So next one, we required a value for debit 500, okay. So one line error is here, colon. Debit 500 is done, then employee number 3, error at line number 7. Line number 7 here. Error like in EMP number, and person EMP number, then debit debit is okay. Okay. I think because of space, it's true. So employee number 3, debited amount 50 rupees, declare डिक्लेयर इज ओके, डिक्लेयर हियर वन प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू सम स्पेस ओनली, बट आई थिंक इट्स कोड इज ओके इफ यू ट्राई इन एसक्यूएल डेवलपर और एनी ऑनलाइन कंपाइलर और रन एसक्यूएल कमांड. सो आई थिंक कोड इज ओके. All of you try this code, it's working or not. Okay. Some of the students says working. No data found. ओके जो हम टेबल यूज कर रहे हैं वो डेटा उसको नहीं मिल रहा है. अकाउंट ACC अंडरस्कोर 6 हो सकता है ऐसा. A001 यूज करके देख सकते हैं. A001 इज वाय आवर एम्प्लॉय नंबर. यहाँ पे प्रोग्राम रन हो रहा है लेकिन जो डेटा फेज होना चाहिए आपके टेबल में से वो फेज नहीं हो रहे या गलत हो रहे हैं. लाइन नंबर 6 आइडेंटिफायर A0 मस्ट बी डिक्लेयर. सो लेट्स चेक. 7,2, name is 20, here 4 and 7,2. Structure is okay. ऑल ऑफ यू ट्राई, ब्लॉक रन हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है चेक करो। ओके, आउटपुट भी चेक करना कि ओके वैल्यू अपडेट हो रही है। डिक्लेयर में प्रॉब्लम है यहाँ पे। डिक्लेयर डी कैपिटल या स्मॉल कोई भी यूज़ तो कर सकते हैं, बिगिन में भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं। ये लाइन रिमूव करके देखते हैं। डेटा नॉट फाउंड, एक बार क्लोज करके चेक करता हूँ मैं। कनेक्शन इश्यू तो नहीं होना चाहिए क्योंकि टेबल एट लाइन नंबर 8। Let's we try with other variable. So instead of a balance, use new variable. I will try this due to the internal compilation error. Let's we try with a integer. Because some of the data type not supported, so you can change a data type and try again. I think this employee number is varchar is not supported. Okay, character data type. We can use a character data type instead of this varchar. So next time we will try and if you want to check, so try yourself. Question number 4. We will try also. This server output is getting some error, unknown set option. No data found. Okay, so keep in mind this is a remaining we will cover. Then try next one, write a PLSQL block for factorial, use if and go to statement. First use if and go to statement and B for loop by using a go to statement, and second thing we use for loop to find a factorial. So how can we work with this program? Factorial. Again, we required a declare section. So I remove all this thing. And in a declare section, write number as an integer. And one fact for factorial integer. Okay. Then number is equal to and percent number. Again is required. Okay, you can use again in a PLSQL block. So what is the use of this again in PLSQL? We repeat all the step. Okay, if number greater than or equal to 1. So we perform each and every operation. You can directly use then here. Number is equal to number minus 1. Okay. एंड व्हाट इज एक्चुअल लॉजिक ऑफ फैक्टोरियल? फैक्ट इज इक्वल टू फैक्ट इन टू नंबर, मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ नंबर. ओके, लाइक फैक्टोरियल ऑफ 5 इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट फैक्टोरियल ऑफ 5 फैक्टोरियल. दैट मीन्स 5 इंटू 4 इंटू 3 इंटू 2 इंटू 1. ओके, इज इक्वल टू 120. सो वी रिक्वायर्ड अ माइनस इच एंड एवरी नंबर एंड वी यूज अ फैक्ट इच इक्वल टू फैक्ट इन टू नंबर. ओके, स्टिल कंटिन्यू. वी रिक्वायर्ड अगेन गो टू. सो दिस अगेन इज द सेम एज अ लेबल एज प्रीवियसली वी यूज. ओके, तो गो टू स्टेटमेंट चेक अगेन लेबल दैट्स अवेलेबल इन योर प्रोग्राम एंड एंड इफ वी राइट डीबीएमएस अंडरस्कोर आउटपुट डॉट पुट अंडरस्कोर लाइन. ओके, एंड फैक्टोरियल ऑफ और फैक्टोरियल इज डायरेक्टली यूज अ आंसर दैट्स रिसीव इन अ फैक्ट. ओके, ऑल ऑफ यू ट्राई दिस. Enter any number 5. Factor not declared. Factor is integer. That's already declared. Set server output on is not working. Fact is equal to integer. We define is equal to minus 1, sorry, 1. The value of fact is equal to 1. We declare this. Then the number is integer type. It's okay. Factorial, then begin. Number is equal to and percent number. Again is one label we use here. If number greater than or equal to 1, then factorial is equal to factorial into number. Okay, then number is equal to number minus 1, and this is a semicolon. Go to again. So label check again, then end if, then dbms underscore put underscore line will print. Okay, now change with this code. Is equal to symbol encounter a symbol is equal to when accepted one of the following All of you write your enrollment number underscore name for attendance. So this is some changes in the coding. Like frequently we use is equal to sign, but here colon is equal to. So need a changes according to requirement of PL SQL block. Again, what is this error? Encounter DBMS underscore output. Okay, so we will cover it in the next session. Okay. And if also cover this semicolon. Go to combine word and check again. Okay, so this is your actual output. To perform a factorial, PL SQL block procedure successfully completed. Okay, thank you for attending the session. We will cover the remaining question number 4 in the next session. So I stop this sharing. Our host is waiting here. So I collect your attendance from chat box. Thank you. I end this session.